Dear students, in the previous class we have discussed what is technical progress and how to represent technical progress in production function. Now we discuss how technical progress contribute to the rate of growth of output over time. We know that rate of growth of output is a function of rate of growth of inputs, but it has been observed that rate of growth of output is much higher than the rate of growth of conventionally defined inputs, capital and labor. Historically, the rate of growth of output exceeded the rate of growth of conventionally defined inputs. Now the question is, why or how the rate of growth of output exceeds the rate of growth of inputs? One reason is technical progress is continuously taking place, and technical progress contributes to rate of growth of output. So in this class we discuss how we decompose the rate of growth of output into the rate of growth of inputs and also the rate of growth of technology. To do that, we write the production function as Q is equal to AT F of K and N. Q is equal to AT into F of KN. Now, a subscript T is added to A. And as we have defined in the previous classes, A is an index of technology. It is known as the total factor productivity, also known as solo residual. Now, AT measures all the influences that determine Q other than capital and labor over time. The subscript T, because it is assumed that A is a function of time. So the change in A over time represents technical progress. As such, we also assume that dA by dt is greater than zero. This d, when we differentiate a variable with respect to time, it is known as a time derivative. Time derivative. So we assume that dA by dt is greater than time, means A is an increasing function of time. So A is the variable representing technology, and we assume that it is an increasing function of time. Now, in order to see the rate of growth of output over time, we differentiate Q with respect to time. dQ by dt. Q is a function of A, K and DL. It is not a partial derivative. Remember this, we are differentiating with respect to time. That is, we are considering the rate of growth of output over time. Rate of growth of output over time is equal to dA by dt into F KL. FKL, small letter capital KL, plus EFKL, so dA by dt, dA by dt into FKL plus A into DFKL by dt. We consider it as a function of A and also a function of inputs. So dA by d2 into f of kl plus a into dfkl by dt. Remember this, it is d, not d, dou, because it is time derivative. Now this is equal to dA by dt into q by a, because q by a is equal to fkl plus then a, sorry, fkl is q by a and a is equal to q by fkl into dA by dt into q by a plus q by fkl. A is equal to q by fkl into dou of dou f by dou k into dk by dt plus dou f by dou l into dl by dt. That is rate of change of output with respect to capital into rate of growth of capital plus rate of growth of output with respect to L into rate of growth of labor. Now this can be written as is equal to, now this is dq by dt. Now assuming that we divide throughout with q, then you will get it as dq by dt by q is equal to division by into 1 by q will give you dA by dt, dA by dt, I write it as dA by dt divided by a, because this q and 1 by q will be cancelled, plus dou f by dou k into a q here divided by q, q and q will be cancelled, so dou f by dou k into dou f by, I write it as dou f by dou k by f of k l into dk by dt plus division by q dou f by dou l, dou f by dou l by f of k l into dl by dt. Now that is dq by dt by q is equal to dA by dt by a plus dou f by dou k into k by f kl, f of kl into dk by dt by k, that is multiplied and divided by k, plus dou f by dou l into L by F KL into DL by DT by L, L and L will be cancelled. That is DQ by DT by Q. Here we multiply and divide with K, multiply and divide with L, you will get the same expression. Now this is, this can be written as, this dA by dt by A can be written as gA. I write it as dA plus, I write this dou F by dou K into K by, I write dou F by dou K into dou F by dou K into K by FL as E Q K into G K plus I write dou F by dou L into L by F K L as E Q L into G L. So what I did here is, this dq by dt by q is the rate of growth of output gq. dq by dt by q, actually it is dq by q with respect to time, that is rate of growth of output. This can be written as dq by dt into 1 by q, and can be written as dq by q into 1 by dt, or dq by q by dt, that is nothing but the rate of growth of output is equal to rate of growth of technology. Then dk by dt by k is rate of growth of capital. This is rate of growth of labor. Now what is this? And what is this? This term is dou F by dou K into K by F K L. This is elasticity of output with respect to capital. Delta Q by delta K into K by Q. Delta Q by delta L into L by Q. So elasticity of output with respect to capital. This is elasticity of output with respect to labor. So the rate of growth of output is equal to rate of growth of technology plus rate of growth of capital multiplied by elasticity of output with respect to capital, rate of growth of labor multiplied by elasticity of output with respect to labor. Now this part is the contribution of technology to output growth. Contribution of technology to output growth. Let me consider a numerical example to clarify this point. And this is based on an estimate by Solo for the US economy from 1909 to 1949. GQ, that is rate of growth of output, was 2.75% per annum, and rate of growth of labor was 1%, rate of growth of capital was 1.75%, elasticity of output with respect to labor was 0.65%, elasticity of output with respect to capital was 0.35. For the aggregate economy, it will be 1. Now we can write GQ as equal to GA, GQ as, and remember this, in the previous class, we have mentioned that GA or productivity is measured as a residual. So we can write GA as equal to GQ minus EQK into GK plus EQL into GL. So GA is equal to, what is GQ? 2.75 minus 0.65 into 1 minus 0.35 into 1.75. That the solution will give you 1.50. GA is equal to 1.5. Now, as you can see, for the US economy from 1909 to 1949, the rate of growth of output was 2.75. Of this, more than half, 1.5%, was due to technical progress, and 1.25% was due to rate of growth of capital and rate of growth of labor. And this signifies the importance of technical progress. This is a very vast area. You will study more about the criticisms of Solow's estimates and associated issues when you study development economics in detail. So the point is, in the long run, the rate of growth of output cannot be attributed to rate of growth of labor and rate of growth of capital alone. It is also attributed to the rate of growth of technology. Solow's estimate shows that more than half of the rate of growth of output is due to rate of growth of technology. Now let us see how we represent technical progress in the Cobb-Douglas production function. Now, we know that the Cobb-Douglas production function Q is equal to ATF KL can be written as Q is equal to AT K raised to alpha L raised to 1 minus alpha. We assume that technical progress occurs at a constant exponential rate, given as AT, technical progress takes place at a constant exponential rate theta. AT is equal to A e raised to theta t. Technical progress takes place at a constant exponential rate. So that we can write Q as equal to A e raised to theta t, K raised to alpha, L raised to 1 minus alpha. We can write it as L raised to beta also, no problem. Now, we give a logarithmic transformation. Log Q is equal to log A plus log e raised to theta t is theta t itself. Log e raised to theta t is theta t itself plus alpha log k plus 1 minus alpha log l. Log q is equal to. Then d log q by dt is equal to d log a by dt plus d log a by d log a by dt plus d theta t by t plus alpha d log, or we can write it directly as, without going into d log q with respect to dt, d log q by dt is equal to d log a. A is a constant with respect to t is 0, then d log, sorry, then d theta t by t, that is theta, is equal to theta plus d log q by dt, theta plus alpha d log k by dt plus 1 minus alpha d log l by dt, d log, that will give you theta plus alpha d log k is dk by k plus 1 minus alpha dl by l. So d log q by dt is dq by q. So dq by q is equal to, in the previous explanation it was dA by A, that is the rate of growth of technology. Now we assume that technology grows at a constant exponential rate theta. So A t is equal to A e raised to theta t. So theta is the rate of growth of technology, exponential growth. Alpha and 1 minus alpha are partial elasticities with respect to capital and with respect to labor. So dq by q is equal to theta plus rate of growth of capital, rate of growth of labor multiplied by their respective elasticities. If you are giving it as beta, you will get a value beta here, that is all. Need not be linearly homogeneous. Need not be linearly homogeneous. So in the Cobb-Douglas production function, you have elasticities. So you will get a rate of growth of inputs multiplied by their elasticities. In the previous case, it was EQ, K, EQ, L, instead of it was DA by A. That is the rate of growth of technology. Now it is explicitly modeled as exponential growth. Technology is growing exponentially given by this equation where the rate of growth is theta. That is it. So this is how we represent technical progress in production function. How we represent technical progress in production function. And remember this, the measurement of technical progress as a factor contributing to rate of growth of output is a very important area in the context of development economics. To clarify a point, let us consider a simple numerical example. Suppose that A is equal to 10, theta is equal to 0.03, alpha 0.5, and K L is equal to 4. 0.03 means 3%. Technology is growing at a rate of 3%. A is 10, index of technology, and it is growing at a rate of 10%. When t is equal to 0, you have q is equal to 10, q is equal to 10, this is the growth rate of technology is a t is equal to a e raised to theta t. When t is equal to 0, e raised to 0 theta 1, then a is equal to 10, then k 4 raised to 0.5, l is also 0.5, that is equal to, solving this you will get TQ as equal to 40. Then when T is equal to 20, Q is equal to 10, e raised to e is equal to e raised to theta 0.03 into 20. Then k raised to 0.5, l raised to 0.5. That will give you 10 into, solving this you will get it as 1.82 into k 4 raised to 0.5, 4 raised to 0.5. That will give you 72.8. So after 20 years, output increases from 40 to 72.8, even though K and L are constants. This increase is due to technical progress. And the increase in output due to technical progress can be attributed to, here it is 10, yeah. Here it is 10 into 1.28, that is 18.2. Now, there is one point here. This technical progress, can we attribute this to an increase in labor productivity or an increase in capital productivity? The answer is no. That requires further complicated analysis. For the time being, just assume that at time is equal to 0, output was only 40. At t is equal to 20, it is 72.8. It augments both the capital and labor. Capital become more productive, labor become more productive, so that output is increasing. And further issues you will study in the context of development economics. And this is how we represent technical progress in production function.